We begin on Christmas Eve with me, Mark, and my roommate, Roger. We live in an industrial loft on the corner of 11th Street and Avenue B. It's the top floor of what was once a music publishing factory. Old rock and roll posters hang on the walls. They have Roger's picture, advertising gigs at CBGB's in the Pyramid Club. We have an illegal wood-burning stove. Its exhaust pipe crawls its way up to a skylight. All of our electrical appliances are plugged into one thick extension cord, which snakes its way out of a window. Outside, a small tent city has sprung up in the lot next to our building. Inside, it's freezing, because we have no heat. Smile. December 24th, 9 p.m., Eastern Standard Time. From here on in, I shoot without a script. See if anything comes of it instead of my old shit. First shot, Roger, tuning the Fender guitar he hasn't played in a year.
This won't tune,
so we hear. He's just coming back from half a year of withdrawal.
Are you talking to me?
Not at all. Are you ready? Hold that focus steady. Tell the folks at home what you're doing, Roger.
I'm riding one great stone.
The phone rings.
Saved.
We screen, zoom in on the answering machine.
Beep.
That was a very loud beep. I don't even know if this is working. Mark, are you there? Are you screening your calls? It's Mom. We wanted to call and say we love you and we'll miss you tomorrow. Cindy and the kids are here. Send their love. Oh, I hope you like the hot plate. Just don't leave it on, dear, when you leave the house. Oh, and Mark, we're sorry to hear that Maureen dumped you. I say, c'est la vie. So let her be a lesbian. There are other fishies in the sea. Love, Mom.
Tell the folks at home what you're doing, Roger.
I'm riding one great stone.
The phone rings.
Yes.
We screen.
Beak.
Chestnuts roasting.
Collins!
I'm downstairs.
Hey!
Roger picked up the phone?
No, it's me!
Throw down the key.
A wild night is now preordained.
I may be detained.
What does he mean? What do you mean, detained?
Ho, ho, ho!
Betty, shit!
Dudes, I'm on my way.
Great, fuck!
I need the rent.
What rent?
This past year's rent, which I let slide.
Let slide? You said we were golden.
When you bought the building.
When we were roommates.
Remember? You lived here. How could I forget? You, me, Collins, and Maureen. How is the drama queen?
She's performing tonight.
I know. Still a production manager.
2 days ago, I was bumped.
You still dating her?
Last month, I was dumped.
She's in love. But she's got a new man.
Well, no.
What's his name?
Joanne.
Rent, my amigos, is due. Or I will have to evict you. Be there in a few.
The power blows.
How do you write a song when the chords
console. You won't throw up the digital delay. Didn't blow up exactly. There may have been one teeny tiny spark.
You're not calling Mark.
How do you stay on your feet when on every street it's trick or treat? And tonight it's trick. Welcome back to town. I should lie down.
Ever since our wedding, I'm dirt. They'll see I can help them all out in the long run.
Take your AZT. Close on Roger. His girlfriend, April, left him a note saying we've got AIDS before slitting her wrists in the bathroom. Change your mind. I'll check upon you later.
But one great song before I
on the floor.
I didn't recognize you without the handcuffs.
Freak light the candle.
And don't forget, my performance, Over the Moon, protesting the eviction of the homeless and artist in the 11th Street lot, tonight at midnight in between lots A and B. Party at the Life Cafe to follow.
Well, Joanne, we're off. We called you at the office, and they said you were stage managing or something.
Remind her those unwed mothers from Harlem need her legal advice, too.
Call Daisy for our itinerary, or Albert at Pound Ridge, or Aileen at the State Department in a pinch. You'll be at the spa till New Year, unless the senator changes his mind.
Oh, the hearings.
Oh, yes, kitten. Mummy's confirmation hearing is on the 10th. We'll need you alone by the 6th.
Harold.
You hear that? It's 3 weeks away, and she's already nervous.
I am not.
For Mummy's sake, kitten. No Doc Martens this time. Oh, and wear a dress. Oh, and kitten, have a merry...
And a bra!
Enter Tom Collins. Computer genius, teacher, vagabond anarchist, who ran naked through the Parthenon.
Bustelo, Marlboro, banana by the bunch. A box of Captain Crunch would taste so good. And firewood.
Look, it's Santa Claus.
Hold your applause.
Oh, hi.
Oh, hi. After 7 months,
sorry.
This boy could use some Stoli.
Tomorrow for me. Today for you, tomorrow for me.
And you should hear her beat. You earned this on the street?
It was my lucky day today on Avenue A, where a lady in a limousine drove my way. She said, darling, be a dear. Haven't slept in a year. I need your help to make my neighbor's yappy dog disappear. This Akita Evita just won't shut up. I believe if you play nonstop, that pup will breathe its very last high-strung breath. I'm certain that cur will bark itself to death. Today for you, Tomorrow for me, today for you. Tomorrow for me, we agreed on a fee. $1,000 guaranteed, tax-free. And a bonus if I trim her tree. Now who could foretell that it would go so well? And sure as I am here, that dog is now in doggy hell. After an hour, Evita, in all her glory, from the window ledge of that 23rd story, like Thelma and Louise did when they got the blues, swan dove into the courtyard of a Gracie muse. Today for you, tomorrow for me, today for you, tomorrow for me. Back on the street where I met my sweet, where he was moaning and groaning on the cold concrete. The nurse took him home for some mercurochrome and addressed his wounds and got him back on his feet, singing, today for you, tomorrow for me, today for you, tomorrow for me. I said, today for you, tomorrow for me, today for you, tomorrow.
Get your ass off that Range Rover.
That attitude towards the homeless is exactly what Maureen is protesting tonight. Enter Benjamin Cobb, director of the team, married Alfie Gray of the Westport Grays, then bought the building of his father-in-law in the hopes of starting a side business.
Maureen is protesting, losing the performance space.
Stage is partially set up.
Line in.
I went to Harvard for this.
Close on Mark's nosedive.
Line out.
Will he get out of here alive?
Mark.
Hi. I told her not to call you. That's Maureen. But can I help since I'm here?
I've hired an engineer.
Great. So nice to have met you.
Wait. She's 3 hours late.
Someone won't delay, but the cable.
There's another way. Say something. Anything.
Test 1, 2, 3.
Anything but that.
This is weird.
It's weird.
Very weird.
Fucking weird.
I'm so mad that I don't know what to do. Freezing down to my bones, fighting with microphones. And to top it all off, I'm with you.
Feel like going insane. Got a fire in your brain. And you're thinking of drinking gasoline.
As a matter of fact,
honey, I know this act. It's called the Tango Maureen. The Tango Maureen. It's a dark, dizzy merry-go-round. As she keeps you dangling,
wrong.
Your heart, she is mangling.
Me.
And you toss and you turn, cause her cold eyes can burn. Yet you burn and you turn and rebound.
I think I know what you mean. The Tango.
She
moved over on the boys.
More than moon.
I'm getting nauseous.
No.
Annette Himmelfarb, the rabbi's daughter at the Scarsdale Jewish Community Center. It's hard to do this backwards.
You should try it in heels.
She cheated!
He cheated!
Maureen cheated!
Fucking cheated!
I'm defeated, I should give up right now.
Gotta look on the bright side with all of your might.
I pull for her still anyhow.
When you're dancing her dance, you don't stand. Great now.
I feel lousy. Huh. Honey Bear. Pookie! You never called me Pookie. Never mind. We're patched.
The Tango Maureen.
Thank you. Thank you. forgotten one great song before I
living man. Feliz Navidad. Smile for Ted Koppel, officer. Morning.
And Merry Christmas to your family.
Right.
New York City!
Uh-huh.
Center of the universe.
Sing it, girl.
Times are shitty, but I'm pretty sure they can't get worse.
I hear ya.
It's a comfort to know, when you're singing the Hit the Road Blues, that anywhere else you could possibly go after New York would be a pleasure cruise.
Now you're talking.
Whoa.
I'm thwarted by a metaphysic puzzle. And I'm sick of grading papers that I know. I'm shouting in my sleep, I need a muzzle. All this
so let's open up a restaurant in Santa Fe. Sunny Santa Fe would be nice. Let's open up a restaurant in Santa Fe and leave this to the roaches and mice. But my students would rather watch TV.
America.
America. You're a sensitive aesthete. Brush the sauce onto the meat. You can make the menu sparkle with a rhyme. You can draw my gentle drum. I could seat guests as they come, chatting not about Heidegger, but why. Let's open up a restaurant in Santa Fe.
I'll see you at the show tonight. I'll try and convince Roger to go.
Alone at last.
He'll be back, I guarantee.
I've been hearing violins all night.
Anything to do with me? Are we a thing?
Darling, we're everything.
Live in my house, I'll be your shelter. Just pay me back with 1,000 kisses.
Thank you.
Honest living.
Have to.
I had a dream. I found myself in a desert called Cyberland. It was hot. My canteen had sprung a leak, and I was thirsty. Out of the abyss walked a cow, Elsie. I asked if she had anything to drink, and she said, I'm forbidden to produce milk. In Cyberland, we only drink Diet Coke. She said, like barns and troughs and performance spaces, and replace it all with lies and rules and virtual life. But there is a way out. Entered. His name, we have learned, was Benny. Yeah. And although he once had principles, he abandoned them to live as a lapdog to a wealthy daughter of the revolution. A 1, 2, 3, that's bum 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 bum. Ever since the cat took up the fiddle, that cow's been jumpy. The dish and the spoon were evicted from the table and eloped. She's had trouble with that milk and the moon ever since. Maybe it's a female thing. Cause who'd wanna leave Cyberland anyway? Walls ain't so bad. The dish and the spoon, for instance, they come knocking on my doghouse door and I say, not in my backyard, utensils. Go back to China.
Beady bong.
The only way out is up. Elsie whispered to me, a leap, still thirsty. Have some milk. And so I lowered myself beneath her, and I raised my mouth to her swollen udders and sucked the sweetest milk I have ever tasted. Climb on board, she said. It is a harvest moon rose over Cyberland. We reared back. And we sprang into a gallop, leaping out of orbit. I awoke singing.
Over the moon. half and the third. Here?
Oh no.
Wine and beer!
The enemy of Avenue A will stay.
What brings the mogul in his own mind to the Life Cafe? I would like to propose a toast to Maureen's noble try. It went well.
Go to hell.
Was the yuppie scum stopped? Not counting the homeless, how many tickets weren't comped? Why did Muffy Allison miss the show? There was a death in the family, if you must know.
Who died?
Arakita.
Evita.
Mimi, I'm surprised.
Compassion to passion to passion. When it's new to song, to song.
marijuana.
Mine is of Musetta's waltz.
Angel, don't you know I'm one of the ladies who are fashion from the world. I'm a rocket herself with a 10-gallon plastic nickel tube.
In college, we'll be calling his exploits an anarchist, including the tale of the successful reprogramming of the MIT virtual reality equipment to self-destruct as it broadcasts the word, actual reality, act up, money!
I'm not.
Mimi and Roger share a small, lovely kiss.
Viva la vie, Bohème!